The Tale of the Three Brothers by J.K. Rowling.
There were once three brothers who were traveling along a lonely, winding road at twilight. In time, the brothers reached a river too treacherous to pass. But being learned in the magical arts, the three brothers simply waved their wands and made a bridge. Before they could cross, however, they found their path blocked by a hooded figure.
It was death. He fought Chitty. Chitty, because travelers normally drown in the river, the death was coming. They pretended to congratulate the three brothers on their magic, and so they each earned a prize for being clever enough in the bidding. The oldest asked for a wand more powerful than any in existence, so Death fashioned him one from the elder tree that stood nearby. And the second brother decided that he wanted to humiliate Death even further, and asked for the power that would call loved ones from the grave. So, Death plucked a stone from the river and offered it to him. Finally, Death turned to the third brother, a humble man. He asked for something that would allow him to go forth from that place without being followed by Death. And so it was that Death reluctantly handed over his own cloak of invisibility. The first brother traveled to a distant village where, with the Elder Wand in hand, he killed the wizard with whom he had once quarreled. Drunk with the power that the Elder Wand had given him, he bragged of his invincibility. But that night, another wizard stole his wand and slit the brother's throat for damage.
The second brother journeyed to his home, where he took the stone and turned it thrice in hand. To his delight, the girl he had once hoped to marry, before her untimely death, appeared before him. Yet soon, she turned sad and cold, for she did not belong in the mortal world. Driven mad with her personality,
the second brother turned with
As for the third brother, Death searched for many years, but was never able to find him. Only when he attained a great age did the youngest brother shed the cloak of invisibility and give it to his son. He then greeted Death as an old friend, and went with him gladly to passing this life as equals.